I guess you're watching this video because your computer is running with an issue here as you're trying to open a Filmora app recently installed. This row are the problem can start because bink2w64.dll is missing from your computer. It's a somewhat critical error, and all you need to do is watch this video patiently and thousands of matters on your computer. Hello everyone, welcome to Tech Evolution. In this very short video, I'll be fixing this error within 3 minutes. So let's start the countdown. The first thing you need to do is open your favorite browser and search for bink2w64.dll. You can choose any results. I'm choosing the first one. This is not sponsored, but I'll put the link in the description. Here you can see a few download option based on the architecture and version. To know your architecture and version, click on start and search for system information. Here you can see mine is 64-bit and I'm updated to the recent Windows update, so I'll be downloading from the top. I strongly recommend you to read this page. It has other fixing method also. It can be used as a backup process. As the download complete, hit open. The downloaded GIF has two files, one is the DLL and the one is readme. To move the DLL, first open this PC, then local disk C, Windows, and find a folder named system32. This is home of 32-bit DLL files. Then drag the DLL and drop. I have already done this, so it is asking me to replace. And click on continue to give administrator access. Before we proceed, let's check by typing the entire file name. You can see the file is perfectly placed in 32-bit folder. So job done for 32-bit users. You can go and restart your computer. This is the additional process of 64-bit users. You need to open this PC one more time, then local disk C, Windows, and this time find a folder named syswow64. This is the home of 64-bit DLLs, and similarly drag and drop. Now check this once again. Here you can see the DLL file is placed in 64-bit folder 2. And finally, restart your computer. In extremely rare cases, if the error still occurs, you need to download and install Microsoft DirectX from Microsoft official website and install your program again, and that will surely fix it.
And that's all. If you follow me step by steps, you'll no longer have that problems left. Please let me know how you feel about this video. And do not forget to like and subscribe.